Hey guys, it's me, TGP, and honestly, it's been quite some time since I've even uploaded anything or even said anything. I've kind of disappeared from platforms altogether. I won't get too personal, and I'll keep it brief, but essentially, I've had a lot of obstacles thrown in my way, I guess just to test me or whatever. It took some time, but I finally got over it, and I passed through those said obstacles, and I've even took time to better myself by essentially creating a sleep schedule to also keep this very impersonal, but I do work in the mornings, like from 8 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon, 4 days in a row. Then Sundays I work essentially 12 to 8. So I always had a hard time with sleep ever since I got that schedule. But now I've honestly been working better to fix that. Now I've even decided to do better for myself and, for example, go to the gym. I'm not going to say I'm like dissatisfied with the way I am, but at the same time too, I should be taking care of myself better. So, and with some help, I actually I decided to essentially do that and like go to the gym and work out and eat better as well. So this said, I'll come back. I am coming back at some point. I just wanted to make a video of some sort about it. Yeah, I just needed some time off. I've kind of stayed away from electronics for a while. Like, I used my phone for like a while, but I've kind of been like staying away from computers for a while and even video games. Like, I'll play here and there, but now I'm back to my normal self. But even so, I won't be as active. I guess I should say that. But I'll be around for sure. I'm actually gonna be coming back to Discord after this, because I haven't been on Discord for a very long time, except for when like personal friends wanted to talk to me or whatever, and I did just that. I should also mention, some people have actually reached out to me. They're like, hey man, where have you been? It's been like a long time. And I appreciate you guys, and I'm sorry for disappearing like that. I don't want to do that again. But it's actually, it felt really nice to know that people actually did care about me. But anyways, let's not get too depressive. Let's also get into the meat of this video too, because this is not just a video talking about where I've been. Essentially, I want to talk about two big things. Content that's coming in the future, and this big old patch that's coming up in Fire Emblem Heroes. Just because I was gone for a while, that doesn't necessarily mean I miss things to do in Fire Emblem Heroes. I've actually been keeping up with it quite a lot, actually. I've recorded majority of the stuff that I was able to. So, for example, I have the Legendary Ryoma battle, I have the Bound Hero battle, I have the Grand Hero battle with Linus, and the things that are currently now. The only one I don't have is Oliver, because I don't know, I just didn't have time, and I can't defy God like that. You know what I'm saying, dog?
Oh!
But anyways, actually, I'm going to upload one tomorrow. I'm going to upload the Legendary Ryoma video. I'm not going to say I have, like, a set schedule for them to come out, but I'm going to keep them, like, I don't want to upload daily. I just want to, like, space them out a bit. I don't want to just, like, you know, not upload everything and then have nothing left over. So yeah, do expect some uploads to come up at some point. And I've also been working on some things in the background as well. I won't get into it until I fully finish them, but they're not necessarily Fire Emblem related. It's been stuff I've been always wanted to do, so do expect that in the future as well. I wouldn't say near future, but it'll be there at some point. And then also, besides this, I'm actually going to also record the Grand Conquest. I might try to push that out today, since today is indeed the last day of me recording this. I don't know, we'll see. But that's about it for stuff I'm going to do for the channel and whatnot. Now to talk about the other big thing, which is this patch that's coming up in July 8th. I saw it. I reacted in certain ways, but I'll react to it when I get to it. However, I want to get the small things out of the patch first, because those smaller things I really don't have very much to say. So I'm actually going to start here at the bottom, but basically the small improvements are essentially on the map screen selection. The screen will always automatically scroll to newly added maps. Battle music is being added to the settings menu, so background music that plays during the battle scenes can be toggled on or off, so it can be set to play only special battleground music. Event recap is being added to the miscellaneous menu. This feature can also be used to review conversations from past events. And a restart option is being added to the menus in the Grand Hero Battle, Tactics Drills, and other maps that can be played without using any stamina. So that's nice. I think one of the biggest complaints from beforehand when they added the toggling of the music is the fact that the battle music still played. So that's cool, I guess. I didn't mind it, because normally when I record these, I turn the music off anyways and I add my own. So, I mean, it's nice when I'm playing, like on my own, or if I'm doing some grinds and whatnot. The event recap, this is really cool, because things like the Tempest Trials and whatnot, you really can't see them, but now you can, so that's always cool. And the restart option, that's actually really nice. I mean, whenever I record, I usually just quit out anyways, just to keep the video in one smooth take. But having a restart option is actually really, really cool. And the fact that it doesn't take any stamina, although if you really think about it, a lot of these maps don't have a use for it, but like the Grand Hero Battles and whatnot, but it does have its uses, so it's really nice that they added that feature. The next big thing about this, the third big thing is they're changing the quest progression display, which is, I'll have to see it, because I honestly don't understand it myself, but I'll read it anyways. The screen that is displayed when you complete or make progress in the quest is being changed. Currently, a separate screen was displayed for each quest, but starting with the 2.0 version screen, all quest updates will be displayed in a single screen. Actually, okay, now that I've read it, I actually do understand it better. Basically, if there's like multiple quests, you get to see them all instead of like lots and lots of different squares. I didn't mind it either way, but the fact that I make it simpler, that's nice. Cool. Thank you, I guess. And now for the second biggest thing, and actually it's something I'm pretty excited about. They're gonna have tactics drills, which is let me read it first. Tactics drill is being added as a way to learn the rules of Fire Emblem Heroes as you play. And the tactics drills will be represented. In tactics drills, you'll be presented with situations that test your strategy with a fixed set of heroes that you must use to overcome challenges within a given number of phases. Both your turn and your enemy's turn are counted as individual phases. So if a map specifies that it must be completed within 3 phases, then you have your turn, your enemy's turn, and one more of your turn to complete the map. There are 3 levels of difficulty for tactics drills, and you will receive awards such as orbs or hero feathers for the first time you complete a map. Basics. These maps teach you the basic rule of combat, so they're recommended for beginners. Skill studies. These maps teach you about using various skills. Grandmaster. These maps are meant for advanced players. Note, you must complete Book 1, Chapter 13 of the main story to challenge the Grandmaster maps. Once version 2.7.0 has been released, we will add new maps to either skill studies or Grandmaster every Thursday at 3 a.m. So the thing that makes me really excited about this is it gives me a gigantic, huge reminder of Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel puzzles, which were always my favorite thing. I've always been a big fan of like puzzles and things to like kind of tease your mind as to what to do, and in a way to teach game mechanics as well. I mean, I can't say for sure if I'll learn anything new, but hey, I wouldn't mind a surprise here and there if I learn something about a skill. But yeah, I'm like a huge stickler for these types of little puzzles. And again, they gave me huge vibes for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel puzzles, which I was a huge fan of. So that's really cool that we're getting something like this in the game. Plus, it's another way of getting more orbs. So there you go. And now, last but not least, the biggest thing, in my opinion, and even why I'm making this video to begin with, is weapon refinery updates. So, three units are getting brand new weapons, and one unit is getting essentially a weapon upgrade, I guess you could say. So, the one getting the upgrade is Eldigan with Dark Mistletane, so that's really cool. Then we have Katarina with Rhys's Tome. We have Titania with Draconic Poleaxe. And finally, last but not least, Nephenee with Dauntless Lance. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Anyways, so as far as I'm aware, I don't think Nephenee ever got a special weapon of any sort. Not that I remember, it's been years since I've played these games, but I don't think she ever got anything special, to my knowledge. So the fact that she's getting a weapon, and the fact that is really nice, but I would not have the slightest clue as to what they'd do. It could probably be related to Wrath in a sense, because that's kind of her niche, so that'd be really nice. As for Titania, it's a poleaxe. It's probably gonna kill horses, but it being a draconic axe, that could honestly mean several things. It could also mean that it's a dragon killer, and I haven't built her. I have her, but I just have not built her at all, so I honestly do plan on building her once and for all. And Katarina, that girl needs something. She's just so meh. And hopefully this tome kind of like sparks that revival a bit, because I have one and I just haven't touched her at all. I just had no need to, since she was so meh. But hey, hopefully that tome does make her usable. If IS was able to make Merrick somewhat usable, I'm pretty sure they could do some pretty good jobs. It could probably be like, I don't know if it'd be like an owl tome, but it can probably have like some sort of chill. It could probably be like an owl tome, but like with range instead of having to be next to the unit. Who knows? I never played her games, so I wouldn't necessarily know what her things can be, but we'll see. And also, Eldigan is getting the Dark Mistletane, which, honestly, I don't know how to feel, because on one end, being Fury 6 man is the best man, but being able to essentially keep your specials is kind of pretty good. Like, it does need some sort of setup, but once you get it, it's kind of hard to kill him, especially with using skills like Vantage to always like keep that, which is pretty cool. But honestly, I'd just keep, I don't know, I'd have to like someday look into him. But another reason why this gets me very excited is because with every refinery weapon update comes a banner. And you know what that means. That finally, after all this time, I can get myself a fucking Eldigan, for God's sakes. I have played this game for over a year now, and I have yet to get this man. But okay, I'm just kidding. It'd be nice to get Eldigan, but really, I think it's time to plus 10 Nephenee once and for all. So do expect a summon video for that one. I will be saving all my orbs. I mean, I'll be spending a little bit here because I'm trying to get something from this legendary banner, but otherwise I'm literally ignoring probably all other banners along the way. Like, honestly, every banner when that banner comes out is complete trash to me right now. Except for the rerun summer, I kind of do want Robin. Two of them. Maybe three if I want her, I don't know. But, yeah. All other banners to me are dead. They're just dead to me. I'm going to be saving each and every orb, and I will definitely be spending some money to get that plus 10. So, here's to hoping. Yeah. Wow. I'm anxious. I can't wait. So, yeah, I'll see you guys in another video. You know? Yeah? What the fuck are they gonna do? I don't know, man. I'm just rambling this one. But yeah, so that's all I got for this one. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.